finicky. It all depends on your vision, your ability to show up at Dragon first, and then as everyone is starting on the enemy team to come to that objective.
Just yet.
No, they're just looking to, oh, nice, actually, waiting out the spell shield right there. That's a lot of damage coming through as there's Prey actually flashing forward. There's another flash from Gorilla. First blood to Prey after he lands that chain actually get stunned into the wall as Chaser wants to turn this one around. Chilling Smite onto Gorilla. Gorilla may, in fact, bite the dust right here. He will go down inside the brush, but a impressive all-in. People loading up. TP coming into the bottom side. Jay gets locked up with that root, immediately stapled to the wall, and he's gonna die very quickly. Smeb on the right now. Now there are a lot of Jhin Air players. Gorilla gonna have to use that speed boost, but he gets caught by the Timbers and taken out. Great play. Jhin Air very decisively going all-in. Trace on the other side of the map. Smeb getting burned down here by this rumble. It looks like he will be able to get out, but another tower for Jhin Air. Ku trying to be cute. Thing is, old wisdom there with the Agony's Embrace. Kuro in from the flank. Captain Jack gets chained and then chained again for the kill. Gray mops it up with an auto attack. Che now trying to get a double stun. Does land the W. And Kuro, though, with one more auto, will take out Che as well. Nice decisive play from the Tigers, collapsing onto a flank with that speed, but it's not going to be enough. GBM is going to, actually Trace gets the kill right there as Kuro has to retreat into the end.
Have this double side stone. Just follow your vision with a really aggressive flash. Tibbers instantly kills Prey, and that should be a turret.
And that's how you play this composition. Use that Sivir ult, use the Whimsy and the Heartseed. Wrapping around the side right here, Chilling Smite. Will it be enough? Gorilla there to give him the protection, but Chaser with the knockup. And that'll be a dead tree taken down with the equalizer there to provide a little zone to make them at the Baron, force them to try and face check or be concerned. You're doing it, and there we go. There is a Vayne ultimate right there. Jack gonna pop his ult immediately. GBM finds himself right in the mix though, and Ku will respond with a pick of their own. Smeb
at turret sieging, very good at taking down Barons. Just one of those two, enough to threat, but to Flash Tibbers.
Yeah, Flash Tibbers. Che wants this. He's got to melt in the front line. Good equalizer, though. Kuro is on the outside. He's already had his shadow popped right there. Smeb just doing some zoning work. Chaser coming back in. Gorilla looking for that tether onto the jungler. Has to break it. Wisdom running out of the fight. Kuro, oh, very low. Distortion away, and that will be a one-for-one trade. However, Jhin Air still very healthy. There's the flash forward. Captain Jack going aggressive. He gets the double kill on to Prey, and they're still committing to this. Gorilla caught out for a triple. Smeb has to flash the Dragon Wall. Now TP coming in. Kuro on the flank right now. Can he get it? Can he do something? No. The Baron taken by the time Smeb gets there. Jhin Air pulling it out, and a stun from Che. There will be a kill. Captain Jack running up as well, tossing out a boomerang blade, smackward minion wave, and then back onto Trace right here. They want to go in, actually. Prey can't really do much at all. Wisdom pops the locket, but there's just not enough people right now as Jack gets another double.
Captain Jack slicing through these low armor, low health members. Very smart. Could be difficult. They don't have the best backline damage. Prey and Captain Jack actually dueling. Captain Jack so low. Flash Tibbers.
And Prey's not going to go down. The QSS will save him, but a boomerang blade hits him in the back line. Ku Tiger still going in right there. A lot of damage. Trace getting low, but Captain Jack huge right now. Wild growth and running forward for the triple kill. And that should be it for this one.
They still have a lot of turret damage available. The Blanc, crucially, is at full health, so they might be enough to harangue them away from the Nexus turrets. Four members, though. Rumble can choose to teleport back in, or they could choose the safe route. Jhin Air, they have all the options this game.
Yeah, I think they should just power through right now. They have the minion waves. There's the, probably could have waited longer to TP onto a turret target right there, but Trace still moving forward with those home guard boots, and that's gonna be Jhin Air on the Nexus as they send us to a game three. Very decisive play from Jhin Air.
And credit to Jhin Air playing a comp that we weren't necessarily immediately convinced by, especially given their previous playstyle. Ku staying with much the same, but just outthought by Jhin Air. They changed their playstyle. The Lulu in particular and the speed just got them the picks they needed to take over the mid game.
And Lulu too, actually. GBM building a QSS that game, got some magic resist, and that made him able to position better for Captain Jack. Captain Jack doing a lot that game. 10 kills for his team, but that's how this composition should work. That's where all the kills should be going. You need to make that Sivir strong so she can maximize her damage.
Just justifying the Lulu pick with stacking AP and then just being there to speed up Captain Jack. It's good that they're able to put together a comp like this and win. And Jhin Air making this a series of three.